your room's okay. We are all.
Yes.
He's
gonna be here.
We're live, Gary.
He's been misrepresenting how one of
We're live. Good morning. Well, I guess it's afternoon now, isn't it already?
We're still alive.
Welcome back to the Austin Convention Center. It is noon. It is Friday.
And this is reality.
And we are here with you. Yep, we're just getting rolling. The trade show just opened.
We're on the floor of the trade show, booth 5 and 6, if you want to stop by and see us.
And we're going to be here. There's going to be people here all day. We're doing live show from noon until 1 today. And then also from 4 until 5 with Check This Action, with Margaret Mosier.
With the lovely Margaret Mosier and Jen Harrison.
She said last night that they had a great show yesterday.
Yeah, we've had some pretty good shows from here.
It's been a lot of fun so far. And Margaret and I hung out with the Irish boys last night, and that was a lot of fun.
With Chesley?
Yeah, and then we jumped on KLBJ yesterday, so I was on the radio for the first time last night, with the boys from Chore Boy, quite a rowdy crowd.
So did you go see Miss Multimedia?
I've been Miss Multimedia.
Well, that's good.
Did you go see any music last night?
I didn't see a lot of music because I was with my son, but
I bet he loved that, though. Good.
We went to catch some mariachi.
Very cool.
Music, it's a little off the beaten track. So it was fun.
Well, I went to Maggie May's and saw a bunch of Irish music last night, including this guy named Jack L, who's from Dublin, and looks like a cross between Jim Morrison and Tom Jones. I mean, he's just this, he did the last song. It's just him and an acoustic guitar, and he did the last song with this red boa wrapped around him and got the audience all riled up.
Tom Jones and who?
Tom Jones and Jim Morrison. You know, the guy from The Doors.
I know Jim Morrison. Actually, he's staying in my house. He's not dead.
Oh, is he not dead? He and Elvis. Well, Elvis is actually buried in your backyard, is what I think.
They hang out together.
We've got about, every 5 minutes today.
We've got a bunch of guests. Yeah, we've got Andy Schneider, who is the guy bold enough to put out an 8-track in high-tech times.
Oh, that's why.
He's here. We've got, this guy's probably going to come back and see us, Tim Sweeney.
He's a good guy. I've been hanging out with him a little bit.
And I gather Casey Monahan's over there going to pick a bone with him.
With
Mr. Sweeney.
They're
going to
rumble.
There could be a fight on here live on the Channel 15. And our first guests are these gentlemen over here, I believe.
Dan McKlusky and Dana Aker. And they are here from Berkely College of Music. And we're going to
We
have some education on the show, so are going to get them in here and let's chat with them.
Hey, gentlemen.
Good morning.
Good to meet you.
Hi.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Good to meet you. Welcome.
Let's see. We need to pull some mics out for you guys. Is what we need to do.
Okay, you're There you go.
All right.
Okay.
Good morning, Austin.
This is Dan McKlusky right here.
Actually, Darcy, I don't mean to interrupt, but my name's Kevin.
Kevin?
Yeah.
What in heaven's name did...
I know, there's such similarity between Kevin and Dan.
You know, I got to screw up really good first thing
Check,
in the
please.
Morning. Yeah, well, I'm
Dan's
sorry,
I'm
sorry, you're not getting paid today. I hope you knew that. And this is Dana. And Kevin is the assistant professor at the Berkeley College of Music, professional music department.
Right.
And Dana is the assistant director of admissions.
That's correct.
At Berkeley College of Music. And that's in Boston. And so I guess the first question is, you know, I think people think of this as a music industry professional event, And so what are you guys doing here as members of the university community at the music school?
Should I address that?
Yeah, sure.
You should address that.
Well, we offer a Bachelor of Music in 12 music industry-related majors. We're contemporary music. By that, I mean jazz, rock, country, everything, all that. We have majors in... For instance, film scoring, music education, music therapy, songwriting, production engineering.
Very cool.
Yeah, performance.
Performance.
Is big, yeah.
Like, I know my friend Steve McAllister, who played with Walter Salas Umar and the Silos last night graduated with a degree in bass.
Right.
So I know that there are a bunch of musicians that do, you know, go through the whole university thing, but I think our you know, we think of them as people that start playing music and then just, it just happens like that.
Yeah.
So why did you guys come to town? You guys here to look forward to the future and get some more people into the school?
Well, you know, it's our job as educators is to let people know what's available out there in terms of what they can do for their careers. When I'm a graduate and alumni of the Berkeley College of Music, and when I went to Berkeley, I played guitar with Reeves Gabriels, who's with David Bowie now,
right.
Steve Vai, Dave Rosenthal, who's with the piano player for Billy Joel now, Bruce Coburn, the famous Canadian songwriter, is also an alumni, and as a matter of fact, Bruce Hornsby, who did a special sneak show at the Cactus, I believe on Tuesday night.
I didn't even hear about
that. Is an alumni of the college, and you know, the Berklee College of Music is all about musicians learning how to play, and also about learning about the music industry. And
well, you were mentioning that South by Southwest, you've been struck by the high quality of educational, information,
yeah,
panels and workshops and such that you felt were very useful.
Yeah, well, the panels have always been good here. This is my fifth year here. You know, just as I'm a songwriter and a singer and and I do lots of things in the music business, and I come down here to learn. Just as I guess I could describe South by Southwest as kind of a Berklee College of Music over 4 days. Compact.
You don't get any sleep in school either.
You don't get any sleep in school either. And, you know, I just really want to stress that the probably 85% of the faculty and teachers at the Berklee College of Music are people that are still, I mean, we're all out there playing music. I mean,
very,
you know,
cool.
We play and we work in the music industry and we teach.
Deal. Well, and I know that you guys said that you were going to be coming down here in a couple months to do auditions. Is that true?
That's right. Actually, in December. We'll
be
here.
Pardon me?
Do you have a date for that, or is it just not finalized yet?
Is it December 5th?
I believe it's December 5th.
Yeah.
In fact, we do auditions in Austin every year.
Cool.
So you'll have to let us know, and we'll put it on the channel, let people know.
Yeah, we'll definitely make sure.
Well, it's part of our North American Scholarship Tour.
Uh-huh.
Good deal.
We'll audition in Atlanta, Austin, Los Angeles, Vancouver.
Might want to stay a couple of days here.
Yeah.
Well, listen, we need to wrap things up. We got a full show today, but yeah. I was really pleased to have you guys on. I apologize for calling you, Dan.
That's
I feel
all
really
right.
Bad oh,
thanks
about
a lot,
that.
Austin.
Okay,
we're
and now
gonna
we're
going to
go
video.
To Propeller Heads. We're going to go to Propeller Heads right now. They're playing tonight, so check them out. This is Propeller Heads with Shirley Bassey.
Here we go.
Okay, that was Propeller Heads. They're playing tonight. And Casey, you playing tonight? This is Casey Monahan.
Yeah, I'm playing tonight.
The lovely, the talented.
The lovely, talented Casey Monahan. And your job is, what's your official title?
I'm the director of the Texas Music Office in the Office of the Governor. It's been around for almost 9 years now. We serve as the information clearinghouse for the state's music industry. And we also, in a much more informal sense, we act much as the Chamber of Commerce would for the music industry.
Mm-hmm.
Except that, you know, to be a member, right, you have to be living here. So there's 19 million people that we serve.
And mm-hmm.
There's about 80,000 people in the music industry, and those are our core people.
Now, you've been through how many governors now?
Three. This is my third.
He goes through governors like people go through straws.
Has there been much difference between them? You probably don't want to comment too much.
No, it's nothing. Just like everybody, you know, everybody's got their strengths and weaknesses, and... And, you know, I just feel very fortunate to work with, you know, different people. It's strange reapplying for a job that you already have, but that's something that happens.
It's been done before.
But that's something that happens, you know. I mean, that's just, I mean, I knew that going in and stuff. But
I think people are often surprised when they see your business card because it's got George Bush's name on it.
Yeah, well, he's my boss.
This is brand new right off the bat.
Yeah,
right
it came
here?
Out 2 days ago. Right. I'm here. Should we say here?
Yeah.
Got a visual on that? Did I say that right?
Wonderful directory. So incredibly informative. Chock full of venues and musicians and services.
Yeah, well, anybody that has anything to do with the music biz, if we don't list them in here, we're not doing our job. Here, let's
very
turn
cool.
here to, can we get a visual on this? Right here, all the way down here. Do you see the visual? How close can we get? I'm looking over there at the screen.
There it is.
There.
The Austin Music Network.
So, and every act you have, every act in Texas, pretty much every Texas act is listed in the every manager, every radio station.
If we don't, we're messing up. But you know, but no, seriously, there's about 9,200 phone numbers this year in the book.
So how bigger, how much bigger is it? How many more entries
well,
do we have?
Well, I cut two sections out this year.
Uh-huh.
But it's still thicker than it was before.
It's the same size. I cut the two sections out, but there are about 700 more listings in here than there was in the 97 edition.
Oh, cool.
I used it a lot, actually. I used it a ton last year.
That's
it was very
great.
Cool.
You know,
resources, year-long resources.
So, so that's what I do. Did I answer y'all's question?
Yes, you did.
You did very good.
Well, actually, just and tell the nice folks, are you here as to raise attention about the Texas Music Industry Directory, about
right,
the
sure.
office, and inform people on a national scale, or are you just here to like hang out?
In a real practical sense, Darcy, I'm here to save the state money. In that I get to meet with people rather than having to go to Denmark or Norway or Germany or Japan.
And we all know how much that sucks. Yeah.
I'd love to go there, but I mean, that's not the point. The point is I have a very limited travel budget. The best thing about South by Southwest for me is that I get to meet people in Austin, very easy to get ahead. And I'm sorry. Some disturbances off the screen.
Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain.
I get to save a lot of money, and in a short period of time, get a lot of business done here. So, what kind of business is it? You know, I might be trying to help a European promoter find a Texas sponsor for a European tour of a Texas act. Have some meetings with the Recording Industry Association of America, the lobby group for the major record labels in D.C. Met last night with like five attorneys at one time, and I'm not even an artist.
That's kind of nerve-wracking, actually.
So I
went straight to bed after that.
I went in and I drove home and I played my music really loud.
Blast all that stuff out of your ears.
And also, I've been trying to find that guy Tim Sweeney who says he knows me.
He's going
to
be here.
Do you see him anywhere?
I haven't seen him yet today.
I served this morning.
I guess that's the only downside to my job is a lot of times people say, well, Casey said you should talk to him. I say, well, call me and ask me.
So all I know that he said when we interviewed him before about this book is he said he was most complimentary about you and your job.
Then I appreciate that. I'm just trying to provide some fodder for you know, I know you're up against Jerry Springer in this time period, aren't you?
Did you wrestle?
I believe in sweetness.
We're going to go for another video.
We're going to go to Doyle Bramhall, too, who's playing at Antone's tonight.
Saw him on the street on 6th Street.
Yeah, Doyle Bramhall's got a brand new band that he's showcasing at Antone's tonight. There's a whole bunch of other great bands at Antone's. Check them out. And anything else, let's see it right now. Change
it's
it.
Muy bueno.
Here we go.
And this, for you kids at home, is an 8-track.
Round.
And this 8-track is that someone has just put out an 8-track. This gentleman here, Andy Schneider. Now, why did you put out an 8-track?
I put out an 8-track because I wanted to. And there's no better reason. Because I'm bored with CDs, I'm bored with vinyl, and I just thought it was time. There's never been an independent 8-track release before. They've always been a major label thing, Warner, Elektra, BMG.
Where did you get them made? I made them myself
in my living room. It's a recycling program. You take them and dump them out and load them again.
You're kidding me.
No, I'm not.
How much time does it take to make each one?
It takes about a day to make each 8-track.
How many did you make?
I've only made a few dozen. We're selling them only here in town. And then we're going to be coming out with vinyl later for the lo-fi impaired.
Right. Well, I got a little information. You moved here about a year and a half ago, and that was after coming to South by Southwest like, three times.
This conference is why I live here. The people were so good to me a couple of years ago when I came here, and I saw that there were so many people that want to help artists who want help, who want to work.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
You're showcasing again this year?
I'm showcasing this year.
Tell the nice people out there when and where.
I'm showcasing this year Saturday at midnight at a place called The Library. It's right next door to Steamboat.
I was just in there actually last night for a little while.
It's a nice club.
And it's a nice club. It has a small triangular stage sort of stuck in a corner. And it sounds a little a little bouncy, but yeah. I mean the noise is a little bouncy, yeah. But it's a cool space. It's real long. It's very
typical. What time is that at the library?
I'm actually Saturday at midnight.
Okay.
Tomorrow.
Saturday at midnight at the library.
Cool.
And we are now at this camera.
Right.
And you had used to have a band called 6240, and they are from, you were from Iowa, correct?
I'm originally from Iowa.
Okay.
That's correct.
I don't think I've ever met anybody from Iowa
before. We don't leave. That's the problem. Iowegians tend to not migrate.
Iowegians?
You never heard that?
That makes you sound like you're from Norway or something. I'm an Iowegian. That's so
funny. Iowa. It's pronounced Iowa.
Iowa.
Okay.
Okay, good.
Okay, so what's coming up next? We're supposed to have a video coming up next, I think.
Or we can just keep talking. Did you go out and see some music last night?
No, I was tending bar last night, actually.
Where do you work?
I don't work. I was actually helping a friend out with a party, and then I called it a night, you know?
Yeah.
I managed to get 8 hours of sleep last night somehow, so
congratulations.
I'm feeling...
Congratulations.
My voice doesn't sound like I'm feeling better, but I'm feeling a lot better, I tell you what. It was a long couple of days so far.
Okay, we do have a video coming up. It's Bia 549, and they are playing at the Austin Music Hall tonight, so you can check them out, Bia 549.
They're doing the BMI
party. And we're back here live from the conference floor at South by Southwest, and the album I'm holding, or the CD I'm holding up, is Blackfire, and they are a punk Navajo band. Is that correct?
Is that how you would describe
it? I've never
it?
Heard of a punk Navajo band, and I'm looking forward to hearing some.
Well, let me go through here and introduce everybody. Mitchell is the coordinator of the Native American Showcase, which is coming up, Saturday evening at the State Theater. This is Janita, and this is Jones, and this is Clayson, and this is Clee, and you are the father of these beautiful kids. Very cool. Well, I guess... If you want to say a few words, maybe talk about this first song you want to play and maybe go right into it, we'd love that.
Okay. Well, the first song we're going to do is, it's a traditional song, and it's a traveling song.
Okay.
So.
We're going to go into another song.
Good. Take it on.
Upon the screaming grounds, no respect for the dead. $2 for its relocation. Walk upon the screaming ground, no respect for the dead. You see what you wanna see, there's nothing sacred. We are not Asian, we are not Asian. Decide now, it's a little fence you want to live. Which way do you want to live? How can we choose one or the other? We must resist. Tear down the fences. We will resist. We will resist. Walk upon the screaming grounds. No respect for the dead. You see what you wanna see. There's nothing sacred. There's nothing sacred. You see what you wanna see. There's nothing sacred. There's nothing sacred. There's nothing sacred. There's nothing sacred. Walk upon the screaming grounds. No respect for the dead. You see what you wanna see. There's nothing sacred.
That was wonderful. That was really good. Keith Sokola came on the show yesterday morning about this time, and I was really, really foggy, and it just kind of lifted me up and started me off on the day, and it was great. Yeah. So you want to tell us just a brief little bit, just tell everybody, tell the camera right here, what time it all starts on Saturday. And
starts at 7.
Come up here.
7 at the State Theater, Saturday, March 21st. There'll be 10 native bands from the States and from Canada.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Very good.
And that covers a wide spectrum of music, of Indian music. Is that everything?
Yeah, it's really
traditional songs, contemporary and rock. Yet we're really excited because this is the first ever Native American showcase that South by Southwest is doing.
Hopefully, it'll be the first of many.
Even Aaron MacArthur had a lot to do with that. I'm so thrilled that this came through because that has been a champion of theirs for something they've been wanting to do for a very long time.
And one more time, what time are you guys playing?
We're playing about 11:20.
About 11:20, these guys?
But also, we're doing like our traditional dances, and that'll be at 7 o'clock.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, okay, cool.
We have a traditional dance group.
Okay,
so we can catch it 7 or 11, and we'll stay for the whole show. I think everyone should stay for the whole show. So.
Good deal.
Well, I wish you all the best with that, and you've got 2 CDs out, right?
Yeah.
Yes, we have 2 CDs.
Okay, so go out and buy the CDs, go out and see them on Saturday, and we're coming up to a video next, Billy Bragg, and you can see him on Saturday.
All right, we are back once again after who was that?
Blackfire.
No, the video.
Billy
Bragg. Billy Bragg's playing Sunday night. We're back at the convention center. We're live on the Austin Music Network with myself, Darcy Fromholz, and my co-host Tim Hamblin. And sitting with us right here is Rob Fraboni, and Rob is a record producer. And you really haven't worked with anybody anyone would ever heard of.
No. I'm just getting started.
Our voices sound exactly alike today.
It's like the Rod Stewart Club or something.
Brenda Vaccaro. Rob Fraboni has worked most recently with the Rolling Stones, but also Eric Clapton, Bonnie Raitt, Joe Cocker, Bob Dylan, the band, just about everybody.
So is this guy for real, or is he just making this up?
I don't know. I think he might be making it up. And you're in town, and you're working with a band called Tupelo.
That's correct.
And you said that they were local?
They're a local band.
Have you ever heard of Tupelo?
Tupelo?
I haven't heard of them.
I've heard of Tupelo Chainsex, which was a band.
Heard of Uncle Tupelo.
No, but this is Tupelo.
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 Like,
okay.
As in it never gets that cold in Austin.
I hear with that voice, you know. I'm like, they're really tough.
I know it.
So tell us a little bit about Tupelo.
Well, I met them through... an attorney friend of mine that lives here, mm-hmm. and I came and saw him, and I just felt like there was something there, and yeah. I've been spending about a year developing it.
Okay, so you've been doing artist development with them as well? And
yeah, I've been down here three times over the last year, for a week each time,
yeah.
working on songs and, you know, just doing pre-production.
Have they been doing some stuff in the studio at all yet, or is
Nothing.
That the next step?
This is a starting Sunday, we're at Arlen Studios.
Okay, very good. So you were working with Freddie?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice place.
Very nice place. Yeah. So, you produced the Stones' last album?
I produced three songs.
You produced three songs?
Yeah.
Was it a good, had you worked with them previous to that?
Yes, I worked on Goat's Head Soup.
Yeah.
And as an engineer. And then Keith Richards and I stayed in touch, and we've been good. He's probably one of my best friends all these years. And I was never able to work with the Stones again because. After that, because Keith and I became friends, so I was looked at as biased.
Right, right.
And on this new record, there was a number of producers, so...
Yeah, they had a lot of guest producers
so
there, and that's
I was
cool.
able to get back in the picture. And Keith and I just produced a record called The Wingless Angels that's out on Island.
Right.
Mindless Island, and it's Rastafarian music. Beautiful record. Wingless
cool.
Angels.
Well, I'll tell you what, I am not... I don't get jittery around rock stars at all. You know,
yeah.
I've been doing it for a while.
Right.
Keith Richards, I think, would like send me off into girlish fits. I don't think I would be able to handle it. Be like, hello, I gotta go now. Goodbye.
Yeah, yeah. He's a sweetheart, though.
He seems like I know. I have a couple other people that know him, and they say he's a really good person to hang out with.
Very down to earth
cool.
guy.
So, is 2 o'clock? Is 2 Below going to be showcasing at all during South by Southwest?
Well, actually, they played the other night, Wednesday night.
And then we've
been rehearsing, and that's.
Yeah.
They won't be playing again.
Good deal. You're going in the studio on Sunday, and you expect to have something in the can by.
Well, we're going to work for about 10 days.
Yeah. See what comes
out
of it.
And we're going to cut half the record and then sit back and take a look at it, and then they might have to write more songs or whatever. You know.
Very cool. All right. So, what's going on now?
Well, we're going to go to a video in a minute. But if possible, I've just seen Tony. From Fastball.
Oh, good. We want to grab Tony Scalzo. Why don't you hold on? Just sit tight. And
how you doing?
Do
good.
Some chatting.
Hi, Tim.
So we heard we wouldn't have time to talk to you today. So you've got a very busy schedule, right?
Yeah, I have to leave in about 20 minutes.
Okay. So you got time to sit down with us, or you
sure.
just want to stand
yeah,
up? Okay.
Why don't
you sit
yeah,
down with time. Us and join us?
Hi, darling. Let's get you a mic here.
Okay.
Tony Scalzo, Rob Fraboni,
Hi, Rob. How you doing? Nice to meet you.
So,
what camera am I talking to? I'm talking
Tony
to Tony
is here with the
Tony with Fastball.
Well, when we contacted the record label, they said you were might be too busy, so we're very happy that you can make it down here. We know what a busy guy you are.
I told Darcy I would make it.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh, well, see. I deal with a record company.
I made a commitment, you know.
I really appreciate it.
Sure, no problem. It's a pleasure.
For those of you who... What camera am I talking to? I'm talking to this one.
What's up with your voice there? I can't even hear you.
It's going down, mighty devil.
Yeah?
It's really bad.
You guys got to relax and drink some water.
I've been rehydrating like a crazy woman.
You're not smoking, are you?
Yes. I can't
Uncle
lie at all.
Tony, he'll tell you.
I know. But for those of you that
haven't been listening to the radio,
haven't been listening to the radio, Fastball has a single that is taking the world by storm.
I think they call it a hit.
I think they call it. I mean, and I told Tony the other day, I had to pull over and listen to it. I was so stunned, and then I realized I was like, "Who is this? Who is this?" And then I realized it was friends of mine. I was like, "Yes."
I've heard it. It's good.
It's an amazing. It's
you.
A really.
Thank
it's
you very
it's
much.
A timeless classic. I would like immediately.
Timeless
it sounds
classic.
Like, it sounds like.
Already.
It sounds like cult music. I mean, it's just right there already. It's very cool.
Yeah.
Well, thanks a lot.
I'm glad you came by. You said
you got the video already. You're playing it before.
Uh-huh.
We did the world
much.
Premiere.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, pretty
we did?
Much.
Yeah.
yeah,
pretty much. He said that nobody else
playing. There may be some
yet.
Other places that have had it.
Hey, we get it, and we put it on.
There are other venues for uh-huh. music video besides MTV, in case nobody knew about Austin Music Network.
Thank you, Tony. Yeah, we got it. I think we played it the first day on the live show, and we played,
yeah, that's
it. We played
incredible.
It yesterday.
That's incredible.
So, and actually, it's, as far as dealing with labels, your label has been very helpful to us. So,
well,
just
they're excited.
Uh huh.
They're really excited.
They're
just
very
like
cool.
We are.
So we're very happy. So tell us where you're playing.
Well, we're playing tomorrow night. That would be Saturday night at La Zona Rosa at 9 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
And
then you're out of town for a long time.
We're actually doing a Waterloo in-store too at 5 tomorrow. So.
There you go. If you don't have a wristband, you can probably force your way into...
Yeah, Waterloo will be happening, so...
So that'd be great. Well, that's great to have a chance to see you, and I'm glad
Always
you stopped by.
Yeah.
That's very
sure.
cool.
Okay.
And
so
now we're going to a video.
We're going to go to a video. What are we going to see? Tell me quickly.
We are
going to
see Latrix.
What
the
is
rap,
it?
Lap, the rap. Latrix. The rap.
Latrix.
Latrix.
Okay.
Latrix.
So we're going to go to this. This is Rob Fraboni. We wanted to say thank you very much for coming on the show. Appreciate it a lot.
Thank you.
Tony Scalzo with Fastball. We'll be back in a second.
And this is Latrix. Right? Okay. We are here with Pure.
Hello.
Hello, Pure.
Once again, another CD cover with a cute girl on it. I like that.
Yeah, she is pretty cute.
She is pretty cute.
She's not even real.
No, she's not real, but she
blurry.
Is cute. Uh-huh.
So you guys are playing when?
Actually, we just played last
night. Oh, we missed
night.
You?
Yeah, we tore it up last night at the Liberty Lunch.
Okay, well, was it a good show?
Yeah, everybody thought it was good. So I mean,
everybody can go home, you know.
Okay, conference is over.
Yeah,
ladies,
conference is over. Go home. It's
Pure
done.
Played. They are leaving the building in just a minute after they come off the show. So what else are you going to see at the conference? You going to stay for the next couple
of
days?
Jordan, we're leaving tomorrow. So tonight, there's a few Canadian bands I'd like to see. And uh-huh. I haven't really gone through the guide yet. So
who would you recommend on the Canadian list?
The Inbreds are really good. Uh-huh. The New Grand, they're from Hamilton, Ontario. They're uh-huh. interesting.
Do you guys have a video out?
Yeah, we have a bunch of videos, but we have a new one coming out for the single Chocolate Bar.
Will you promise to send it down to the Austin Music Network so
yes.
we can play it on the air?
I think we can do that.
You think you can manage that?
I could manage that.
We just saw a rough cut this morning, and it's super sexy. I'm verging on dirty, like you know
verging
we were talking
dirty.
About before.
What's the name of the CD? Can I say it?
It's called Feverish.
Feverish. She isn't real, is she?
No, it's a model.
That's a David Leventhal photo.
It's
a really cool.
She is a very cute girl.
Cool. Yeah, yeah. She's not real, though. I hate to tell you that. She's a Barbie doll.
She's kind of Marilyn Monroe-like.
Marilyn Monroe.
He actually makes those and photographs them.
And photographs them.
Yeah.
This is Pure. They're from Vancouver. They showcased last night at Liberty Lunch. They said that they had a dynamite show. This is Dave. That's Jordy right here. I wanted to get on and introduce you. Have you guys been to Austin before?
We were here last year, actually.
Yeah. Did you have a good time?
Of course.
Good deal.
Same as last year.
Yeah, and the weather's better this year than it was.
Yeah.
It's windy.
Yeah, it was cold last night. I was like, I went home and changed. I was really glad of it.
But it's not as cold as Fairbanks.
Nothing is as cold as Fairbanks,
right.
Alaska.
And it's not as cold as Vancouver.
No. What video are we going to see next? Do you know?
China Drama is coming up next, and they will be playing Saturday at Maggie Mae's. So get ready for China Drum. I see we have Beatle Bob here. Is that
Beetle,
correct?
Yeah, coming up. Upcoming attractions are Beatle Bob, the
and Drill
Bobby
Team,
Bob,
I think,
the Man
Drill
About
Team.
Town.
And that's it.
That's it. We're out here.
I'm not quite sure what just happened, but I got to apologize for it, whatever it was. There was a mess up on the video, so what the hell do we know? We're just sitting here on this couch with Ray Wylie Hubbard.
How you doing?
Good to see you here.
Good to be here.
Now, you had your showcase last night?
Yeah, we were at Antone's at 11 o'clock. It was had a real good time. Put together a band, and so I used a bunch of awesome musicians. So
you did? Oh, we like that.
Yeah, it was great. I've been doing a lot of solo and acoustic stuff, playing folk festivals, but playing Antone, it doesn't lend itself to a mandolin, uh-huh. you know, so got Paul Piercy on drums and Ronnie Johnson from James McMurtry on bass and Lisa Mednick. And
Lisa Mednick? Oh,
yeah,
cool.
Man, all right. She's got a great record.
Uh-huh.
So, had Eamon McLaughlin from Silent Street Spankers on fiddle and my guitar player Terry Ware. So we put together a good
that
band.
That is a serious
yeah,
all star cast. That's
and
a
you all
great
missed
collection.
It if you didn't go to Antone.
Well, it was real
night.
Good. You know, I said, I need to get a band together, but, you know, won't rehearse.
Uh-huh.
You know, so. We just got up there and played.
Well,
know?
This is the place to come and get one, I think.
You just have to believe that they're professionals and trusted in
rehearsals
your mind.
Rehearsal's way overrated, you know. So. But we had a good time.
That's
well, it ruins the
for,
spontaneity
right?
of
yeah.
it, you know.
It was a lot of fun.
So, your responsibilities are done now. You get to have a good time.
I'm done.
I
just did a panel with Amy Rigby and about parroting in the music business. And so that was a lot of fun. It was really a neat deal. It was kind of like a support group for... You know, to make sure that it's okay to have kids and play
and
rock and roll.
Play rock and roll.
Yeah, so it's a real good.
So I have a son who's coming up to 3-year-old next month. So how old are your kids?
I got one, but he'll be 5 in May.
Oh, uh-huh. And he's a really neat kid,
he's
too.
A good
I met
kid.
Him at the, the Cactus
right.
Cafe a while back. I am single and childless, just so everyone knows.
But taking offers.
But it was a lot of fun just to know that that's you know there's other people out there. And uh-huh. It was good. It was enjoyable.
So is your son actually here at the?
No, he didn't make it today. He came
it.
In with us last night.
Uh-huh.
We had a good time. But so now I'm done here. I've got a Got a gig in Houston tonight, and then in Dallas Saturday, Sunday, and Monday doing some songwriter stuff.
What's happening on the recording front?
Well, we had some people there last night. The last record was on Rounder Philo, Dangerous Spirits, and so they were there last night. So they're going to probably be doing another record, hopefully this year.
Great.
We did the last two here in Austin. We just got Lloyd Maines and a bunch of the players and went into Cedar Creek and cut the thing. And
you were out at Cedar Creek?
Yeah.
Very nice.
So it's
a really great space.
I'm living in Wimberley now.
You are?
Yeah.
Cool. So you're a local boy, pretty much.
Yeah, local. Yeah. I lived in Austin back in the late 60s and early 70s, so I'm back down here now.
Back when you were a redneck? No. Darcy said we wouldn't say that.
That's all right.
But I did.
Well, you know, it's a wonderful song. I mean, you know, it's a wonderful song, but it really is a song that refuses to die.
It refuses to die, you know. Thank you for not mentioning it.
We would never mention Redneck Mother on the air. We would never do it.
Well, thank you so much for being with us, and best of luck, and we'll see you around.
I appreciate it.
Appreciate it a lot. Thanks for coming by.
And next up is The Promise Ring. Hopefully, we'll get that video straight. Thanks.
Hey, that was The Promise Ring. They're going to be showcasing, I believe, tomorrow night. And I am sitting here with someone that just tickles me very much. This is Beatle Bob, and Beatle Bob is known, I don't know, far and around as a dancing man.
Well, yeah, actually a critic, also a disc jockey, but mostly known for dancing at a lot of concerts and doing my thing in front of the stage, sometimes on stage.
And you're out of St. Louis, and you've been there all your life? That's where you've
been born and raised.
Somebody told me the other day, bread and buttered. I was bread and buttered in St. Louis. And you're still in St. Louis, and you disc jockey, and you also write.
Yeah, public radio station here, KDHX, 88.1 FM. Write for a couple magazines. I'm doing reviews for Jetlag magazine for this particular festival, South by Southwest. And freelance for several others across the country as well.
But the first place that I ever saw Beatle Bob was at Jazz Fest.
Yeah.
And you just told me you've been to 12 of them.
12 in a row, and I would have been to more if I would have found out about it much earlier. Really? I'm sure we all would have.
I asked him what his favorite festival was, and he indeed said it was Jazz Fest. And you're here, and you've been going out and seeing music and having a good time?
Oh, having a blast. I mean, just like Jazz Fest or any of these major festivals, there's so much good music going on all at the same time. You circle stuff that you want to see, and you go back and you say, oh my God, there's three
things. And then
things.
You end up seeing stuff that you didn't even circle,
that's
too.
Right.
I do you that like, all
oh,
the time.
It's crazy.
Better than you thought the first bands were going to be.
Right. It's pure bedlam, but it's a real nice insanity.
Good. I'm very glad. Well, I work for a conference down in New Orleans, which is happening next year between the two weekends of Jazz Fest.
LMNOP, right? I'll be down there. In fact, I'll be on one of the panels.
Oh, dynamite. Very cool.
So what are some of the biggest concerts you ever danced at?
I had the honor, I'd say the biggest honor I've ever had was dancing on stage with James Brown at a club in St. Louis called Club 54.
That was an honor.
He invited me up there, so that was really
Well, listen, we are going to slide you off and pull up another band, but I'm really glad to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm very pleased you came on.
Keep on dancing.
Okay.
I'll see you at
Jess.
See ya.
Okay, we're
going to slide Mr. Beatle Bob out of here.
Let's drill these drill team boys in.
I appreciate it.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Hello.
Good to meet you.
Hi.
Hey.
Hello, sir. How are you? Who are you?
I'm Tim.
Tim, how are you today?
I'm just fine.
Seatman here.
It's all squeezed in.
Which one?
Here, you can talk.
Not check on
Sam. Oh, Mojave 3.
All right.
They never showed up, Mojave 3.
Here we go. We are talking with Drill Team, and this is the most people we've had on the couch so far. I'm really thrilled. Hi, guys.
Hello. How are you?
How are y'all doing? So who wants to tell me something good?
Want to tell them about how they took all of our drugs on the road? Maybe not.
Tell me a little bit about when you're showcasing, where you're playing. Tell me about your CD. Just give me a quick rundown here.
Well, we're playing at Babe's. Thank you. We're playing at Babe's Saturday. It's like the UN. We're playing at Babe's on
Saturday.
There. On Saturday at 1 o'clock a.m. And we have a new... What?
Actually, we're playing right after Corey Glover's solo
Corey Glover's
project.
Solo project. Yeah. Famed Living Color. Great TV show.
Corey's opening for us.
And that would be Drill Team, name of the band. Here we go.
Look at that fine.
It's a fine CD, People of Austin.
Quality. And we just got it, in fact, a couple of days ago.
Brand new? So that's really exciting. It's coming out Tuesday. And you guys did this yourself?
Yeah.
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 Well, I mean,
with the fine people of Reprise.
All by ourselves.
We don't kern type ourselves. You don't worry about that.
And do you have any videos yet?
No.
No? No. Will you send us one to be on the network?
Just home. Actually, we kind of do, though, because you have your... Apollo Stranger, our drummer, went to Greece a couple of months ago.
Shot a film.
And he shot a film with his girlfriend on the rocks of Gibraltar.
Right.
We're going to put that out.
But we should play that on the air, though.
Unless they're shooting in Milos.
Actually, that would probably play.
Okay, I've been told that I've got to wrap it up, but these guys are playing where and when?
Babes, tomorrow night, 1 o'clock. Huge show.
Come on down. Go see Drill Team.
Thank you very much.
All right, we're going to a video. We'll be back.
And we're going to video. Mojave 3 is coming right up, I believe, if we get it right.
Hey, we are back live at the Austin Convention Center, South by Southwest, Day 3. In that last segment, you saw Drill Team and also Beatle Bob, Dancer Extraordinaire. I'm being smooched at, like, in my ear. We have a couple different people with us. We have...
It's all very different. Yeah.
Say night and day.
We have right over here, this is Chris. He's the drummer for a band called 50 Mission Crush. They're an Austin, Texas band.
Absolutely.
Welcome.
Thank
you. Got a CD right there?
Yeah, we have a CD.
Hold it up and let's see if we can get a quick zoom on this and see what we... So everybody can see it.
It's self-titled CD.
My camera is... There's my camera zooming.
Okay.
And you guys are showcasing where and when?
We played last night at Lucy's Retired Surfer Bar. And
it
went real well. We got had some definite label interest, and things are going really well.
Good deal.
We're in the process of doing a national college radio release in Texas, California, Chicago, New York, Indiana, and soon to be across the rest of the country.
Very cool. Sounds like you guys are doing the right things at the right time.
Yeah, we're fixing to have a CD release party on April 3rd at the Electric Lounge, which is a Friday night. So everybody come on out if you get a chance.
Cool.
And then I'm also sitting next to this charming young woman right here. This is Candy Ass.
Candy Ass. Rock band Temptress. We are the new face of rock and roll.
The only all-male girl band.
Yes. And at our show at the Electric Lounge on Sunday night, there's rumor that Shelvis, the trans Velvis, is going to show up.
This is making me nervous.
Elvis
already.
Didn't die. He had a sex change. Yeah.
Elvis didn't die. He's been living in Sweden, ladies and gentlemen.
That's right.
What time are you guys playing?
We're on 11 o'clock.
Well, tell you what, you're going to have fun on Sunday night because Sunday night is always the loosest and the grooviest of the showcase
night. Right, we get the locals out and we're going to have some fun.
Exactly. And that's the time that all the South by Southwest staff kind of relaxes for a second and has a rock and roll
party. That's why they put us on Sunday night. They had to see it too. It's quite a spectacle. It's four straight guys in drag with two strippers. It's a little bit of Kiss, a little bit of Alice Cooper, and a little bit of Rocky Horror Picture Show. So bring your rice.
Are they male strippers being females?
No, this is the females being females with large breasts.
There you go. Now, that's all we really
And I tell
need.
A few jokes now and then. Sometimes I can catch on one or something like that. Yeah.
Well, I think I know where I'm going to be on Sunday night.
Yeah,
I don't know
that's
about
the show to catch.
Else.
This is a show of the showcases,
no doubt.
Isn't it?
So, what size shoe do you wear?
I wear a women's size 18.
Yeah? You're kidding me.
Of course I am.
Well, I don't know. I spent the last 2 days in 3-inch heels, and today I was like, screw it. I'm wearing low heels.
I hate the way it hits the back of your ass, though.
Yeah,
you
it does.
It's really bad.
It gets really low,
Especially after you wear flats. After.
See, men don't understand until they finally spend a little time in girls' clothing.
Do you understand? Yeah. It's like a chick magnet for me, you know. I meet so many women doing this. So I get to go in the ladies' room. Right? It's real easy. You know, and we go in the ladies' room and we can chit-chat. And we bring down all the defenses. I get more cheap feels from women. They're always grabbing my breasts and grabbing my butt.
See, and you know, he likes it. Girls, you know, for some reason.
And I have to reciprocate, so.
It's because there's a big woman-on-woman thing these days.
I call it lesbianism without guilt, is what I call it.
So what you're telling me is you're a lesbian trapped in a man's body.
I'm just a lesbian that's trapped in my own mind.
Good deal. So you guys are going to be playing around town some more?
Yes, we've got a gig at the Back Room next Friday night, our CD release party April 3rd at the Electric Lounge. And you can request it on KLBJ and 101X.
Dynamite. And you, we will see on Sunday night.
Yes, but I have something I have to do.
Oh, no. Uh-oh. Okay. I said that he could do this.
Yeah, baby. There we go.
All right.
Okay. Thank God I didn't get one. Okay. And let's go to a video right now. Before I get one. This is Shallow. They're playing at Babes on Friday night, tonight. So,
in the Austin Music Suite. Yeah, that's a long way
away.
We
can't afford cameras. Never mind.
Yeah, we can't even afford cameras. Yeah.
You've got all these rental refrigerators over the edge of the couch. Where's that?
Well, what we need is a per diem, but we not, you know, I've been looking for a sugar daddy for the network for a while, so.
We all have.
Of course, I need one myself.
Well, up in Denver, we have a lot of respect for what the network's about, and
the
people of Austin should come forth and help this fine institution.
Well, thanks.
Unsolicited, right there, ladies and gentlemen.
And we also, while we're being nice to each other, we can say thanks for the stuff that you send down, because we really appreciate the coverage that you do of the conference that is actually more extensive than we can really do. And so I think it's great that we work together, and we do appreciate it.
We want to come here next year and have you guys still be here.
Yeah.
So
we hope we'll still be here, and we'll. But who knows?
We'd like to send down some of our country-tinged bands, but apparently they spend all their time touring France, where they've become a huge cult item. They just avoid Austin altogether and go directly to France and then start bringing in the Eastern European countries.
It's
happened to 3, 4, or 5 of them. They just slip out before anybody can get their hands on them.
Uh-huh. So have you seen any pop bands in the last...
We just finished up a home video, actually, for Jason and the Scourgers
for Riot Records.
That's coming out in May, and we were... They're at Liberty Lunch last night.
I heard it was a wild show.
Absolutely one of the most phenomenal live bands of all time.
Uh-huh.
And they broke up for a while. They're back, and I can't say enough about them.
The guitarist
Warner Hodges is on fire. Really nice guy.
So they're an amazing band. Stephen, who'd you see last night?
The Amazing Royal Crowns were really good. Sold out show over at Emo's. Junkie XL. Go see Junkie XL, people. Half of Urban Dance Squad and Techno and
half of Urban Dance Squad is in there?
Yeah, it's a Rude Boy.
Oh, I can't believe I missed
Junkie
that.
Junkie XL were a no-show on our show yesterday, by the way.
Oh, that's right. I can't believe I missed that.
I saw that Canadian fellow who has the percussionist that looks like a cross between Elton John and Al Franken. Wonderful. It was simulcast with Canadian International Radio or something like that, so he had to raise a ruckus and sound like local. Oh, what's the fellow's name? A Canadian fellow. He has a Native American name. Wonderful band. Sounded like Greyhound Companion without Garrison Keillor to be interrupting.
Tonight?
They played last night.
Oh. And then I went over to the Sonic Youth show after it got started.
You got into the Sonic Youth show?
I guess everybody else left because the line was so long, and then people started getting in, and they played in 90 minutes.
They did?
Fairly incredible.
Hot damn.
So that was pretty amazing.
Can't win them all. So have you got any tips for the rest of the conference?
Well, those of you that aren't balding middle-aged men in the music biz should pretend to be, because apparently having an immense bald pate gets us into things that, well, if we had a full head of hair, we wouldn't be admitted, because they figure we must have some sort of power and clout and longevity.
Okay.
Also, look for bands based on the Denver Broncos. There's a lot of hardcore, speedcore punk bands coming out of Denver with soul Denver Bronco lyrics. They talk about nothing but the players
and the Denver Broncos.
Point spreads and various plays and stuff like that.
We'll be watching for that.
Sweet.
You're talking about tips, you know, what you who you should see and stuff like that. Kevin Connor from KGSR says, travel in small groups, be flexible, and don't whine.
No whining is always good.
No whining.
Yeah.
And no vegetables. Seems to be the Austin rule. Slabs of meat only.
There are no vegetables to be found.
You can counter it with one banana a day, but beyond that, it's just bad form, apparently.
Okay, we're going to have to probably go now. We've gone a half hour over time, but it's been fun.
Is it time to get out of here?
So I think it's time to go, ladies and gentlemen? So I want to thank these fine gentlemen from Music Link, and I think we're going to go to the outro now, so this is our chance to say bye-bye to everyone. Thanks for everything. Thanks for all the guests and the hosts.
Thank you very much.
It was great being an hour ahead.
We'll maybe see you in the future.